Okay, so today I'm going to show you how to take photographs of the water droplets, like the ones that you just seen. I've seen a lot of videos on YouTube. People are doing it all different ways to get all different effects. Some are very simple and some are like really complicated, where they got all these rigs built up and computers hooked up to it and all that stuff. But anyways, I tried it out with a very simple simple fashion here in my office, and I'm going to show you, I'm going to share it with you how I did it. Anybody can do this with very few simple things. You don't need anything like extra special, I don't think so. But anyways, here is all the stuff that you'll need. My setup is right here. Of course, you need is the camera right here. I got my 1DS Mark III, and then on top of it, I got a flash trigger right there, wireless flash trigger from Canon, and then I have is a macro lens, 180mm. Macro. Then if you don't have the flash trigger, you can also use this dedicated cable right here, you know, so you can attach that to the top one end, and then the other end goes to the flash, and then just put it wherever you want to. But with the wireless, you'll have more flexibility. Anyways, then all I have is I use the one flash. I got two of them. I tried with two of them, and then I tried with one of them, and it didn't make a difference. So I just used one, and I used the reflector on the other side. There's a dish right there with water in it, and then I have another dish sitting underneath to catch any overspillage, and a towel, and of course I got my syringe, which I'm going to use to soak this rag up here, which is sitting on a pole. First I had the pole a little bit closer to the dish, and I shot a few like that, and I wasn't getting like really good results, so I raised it up about 6 inches, and boom, you know, I was getting a lot better result. About the lens choice, 180mm I chose because I have a better working distance from a subject. If I had a 100mm or a 60mm instead of 180, with a 60mm I would be like really close to my subject, and you know, then the water would splash on it or whatever not. But anyways, but the good thing about 60mm would be that it would give me more flexibility as far as depth of field goes, because it's a little bit wider. It would give me a little better form to the droplet. With 180mm, the image is really compressed, and especially when you're looking at the depth of field at the 1:1 ratio, there is not much right there, you know, there is not a lot of depth of field. It's like really narrow even at f32 right there. So if I'm focused at 1:1, I'm not focused all the way in, but you know, just a little bit here, so I can have a little play in there to focus back and forth. But still, I mean, it doesn't give me a lot of depth of field, so that's going to be the biggest problem right there. But other than that, I mean, it's and you have to put your lens in manual focus too. When you're doing macro work, you switch it from auto to manual, because you manual focus it. you don't want the focus to change when you're shooting. Once you're set up, you just want it to stay right there. Okay, so the first thing is camera setting. I'm going to show you how I set up my camera for this type of shoot. I have I put it in manual mode, okay, ISO 100. I'm shooting at f11. If I go above f11, what happens is that because of diffraction, the image starts getting softer. Anyways, it's not out of focus. It'll give you more depth of field, but the image, overall image, will become softer and digital. So I'm leaving it at f11 because I know this lens is the sharpest at f8, f11. So I'm going to leave it at f11 and my shutter speed at 8,000th of a second. Now, a lot of the cameras will only sync to 200th of a second or 250th of a second with the flash. But if you, I have a setting right here where I can turn my transmitter to high speed. Okay, when I put it in high speed, then I can sync my flash to all speeds. So 8,000th of a second would work really good. It'll freeze everything. You can, I have two flashes over here. One is the 580 EX2. I just interchange between those two flashes because I only run them for so long, because they tend to get, you know, if I shoot, because you have to shoot hundreds of images, okay, just to come up with a handful of good ones when you're doing this kind of photography. So you shoot like 30, 40 images with one flash, give it a rest for 10, 15 minutes, and while you're doing that, use the other flash. So in 580 EX2, you will turn it on, and this is already set to slave, but if I press the zoom button down for 2 seconds, it'll start flashing and it'll let me choose to turn it off, master slave, or slave. I put it on slave, set, I'm all set, and on the top it says high speed. It's in ETTL and high speed. And so this flash is all set. And in this one, 580 EX, there is a little lever down here. Okay, it says off, master, and slave. So you're in slave mode, and turn it on. It's on high speed, right there. Okay, right there, high speed, ETTL, and it's all set. Now, when it's all set, this will start blinking. This means it's ready to fire. Okay. I only have one flash sitting right here. Okay. This way, and I'm gonna get this out of the way here. Don't need it. And then my camera is all set. 1/8,000th of a second, f/11 manual, ISO 100, and then what I did was, I have my little dish right here, and I propped it up a little bit on an angle. So I put like a little thing in the back, like a business card holder I have. I just put it in the back so it would be tipping a little bit this way, because I want the light to hit here, and I like this red, and red will hit back into the image, and it really gives a really cool look. And the same way, I have these other dishes of different colors. So I tried these different colors. And the best thing is that these got little circles in them. And the images that came out of here, it really added to the image. And you'll see some of my examples in the end. So here's my syringe. I just fill it up. And I soak my rag on the top, okay? So it will be like right there, soaking the rag, and it'll start dripping. Okay. And it starts dripping right there. And it's pretty constant right there. You know, it's doing a good job. And I will set my dish to where the center is because I like the ripple effects. So I'll set up my camera and you can look at through my viewfinder and see how it looks, okay? And then I'll show you how to focus. So I'll go like this and bring in my camera right there. And then I will turn on my live view, okay? So I can see what's going on. And it's focused right there. I can come in even closer because I want 1-to-1 ratio. And I want to be as close to the closest focusing as possible. And right there. So I can make it look really nice right there. So once I've composed my image, now it's time to focus. So how I'm gonna focus is, here, let's bring this in a little bit tighter so you can see what's going on. Right about there, okay. So what I do is I'll soak my rag again. Let the water drip, okay. Water is dripping. I'll take my skewer, okay, the skewer that I have, and I'll put it on the dish right here where the drop is falling, okay. So I'll bring it to where the drop is falling back there. The drop is falling way back there, so I have to recompose a little bit here. And the drop is falling right here, and so I'll put this right there and let it fall right there, and I'll focus and I'll bring it in a little closer and I'll focus. And maybe even do it 10 times and I'll focus. Get it as close as possible, okay? Now I'm set to shoot. So I fill up my syringe, my flash is on at high speed. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna soak my rag on the top and I'm gonna wait and I'm gonna take a picture like that. I don't know if you can really see that. It's a little bit off. I turn the camera this way and let me do this again right here. Take another one right there. And on this side, I gotta add the reflector because it's not giving me a lot of light. So now let's see if it'll work a little better. There you go. Okay. Camera still has to come just a little bit this way. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this camera on the side so you can see what's going on, okay? So, here is the whole setup. Right there is the setup. Right there. So, what I do is I take my syringe and I soak slowly, let the water settle down, and then take a picture. And keep doing that, and you will, I still have to move the camera a little bit, tiny bit this way. And go ahead, take another one. Oh yeah, that looks good, looking good. And take another one. So the water will be like splashing close and farther away from you. It's not consistent all the time, so your focus, you'll have to check it every so often to make sure that it is where it's supposed to be. And it can be difficult. I mean, you'll shoot a lot of pictures and you'll only come up with like a handful of images, you know. And they're all going to be different. And what I usually do is I wait for this drop to leave the rag. And as soon as it leaves the rag, I click it. So, because of the lag time, by the time it reaches and bounces off the surface of the water, I can, you know, it'll capture the image. So you have to be very patient, but you can come up with some really cool images. Here, I'm gonna put this camera back here so you can see when I'm clicking the shutter, okay? And maybe you can see a couple of these images in the viewfinder if it works out. Let's see. I'm dropping. Yep, see, there's the image right there. And let me do it again. Right there. Right there. Oh, there's another one right there. So, right there. Oh, that one I missed. So, you'll miss a lot too, but if you can see right here, you know, you got different types of images coming through right there, you know. But this red dish is giving such a good, you know, good look, and you can do the same thing with a yellow or blue or whatever, you know. So you don't need anything like super fancy to get the job done. So I'll show you some few examples. This is just the way I did it. I think it's pretty simple and easy, and you can try it some weekend or something, you know, and good luck.